Hi, welcome back to the course Mass Transfer Operations 2. We were discussing on humidification and air conditioning. In the previous class, we discussed the step-by-step procedure of humidification tower design. And today, we will be discussing on the humidification problem. The problem is like that. A cooling tower is to be designed to cool water from 45 degree Celsius to 30 degree Celsius by counter current contact with air of dry bulb temperature of 30 degree Celsius and wet bulb temperature of 25 degree Celsius. The water rate is 5500 kg per meter square hour and the air rate is 1.25 times the minimum. Determine the tower height if the individual gas phase mass transfer coefficient KYF prime is 5743.5 kg per meter cube hour. The volumetric water side heat transfer coefficient is given by the relation HL A prime is equal to 0.059 into L to the power 0.51 into GS in kilocalorie per meter cube hour Kelvin, where L and GS are mass transfer rates of water and air on dry basis. The entire equation is ln PAV is equal to 11.96481 minus 3984.923 divided by T minus 39.724, where this temperature is in Kelvin and pressure is in bar. Before the start of the solution of this tower design, we will recapitulate the step by step procedure of the cooling tower design. The steps are like this. Firstly, we have to specify the inlet and outlet temperature and flow rate of warm water. Say for our practical case, the inlet and outlet temperature and flow rate of warm water is given. Then we have to select the design value of the dry bulb and wet bulb temperature of air. This at the proposed geographical location. Here also in this problem, the dry bulb and wet bulb temperature of air is supplied. Now, then the third step is draw the equilibrium line curve, that is saturation humidity curve, which is nothing but the H prime versus temperature. The enthalpy data are calculated using this vapor pressure equation and the physical properties of the air and water vapor just by H prime is equal to 1.005 plus 1.88 into Y prime into Tg minus T0 plus 2500 into Y prime. That will be in kg kilojoule per kg, where the T 0 or we can say the reference temperature is taken as 0 degree Celsius. Then the fourth step will be we have to locate the lower terminal of the operating line, that is B, on this T L H plane by the point T L 1 and H 1 prime. This point indicates the condition of the bottom of the tower, that is whenever this cold water will be leaving the cooling tower. Then fourth step will be, this fifth step will be this, we have to draw a tangent to the equilibrium line that we have already drawn from this H T diagram, and we have to draw a tangent through this point B, or we can say this whatever the bottom point of the cooling tower. The slope of the tangent gives the ratio of the liquid to minimum gas flow rate, or that is L by GS minimum. Hence, the minimum air rate is calculated, and in this particular problem, the actual air rate is taken as 1.25 times the minimum. And then upper terminal of the operating line is located by this point A, that is whenever we will be getting this GS minimum, and if we multiply by 1.25, we will be getting the actual operating line for this cooling tower. Then we will be getting this A by say the moving through this line TL2, or we can say this one, in which temperature hot water is entering at the top, and whatever the slope actually we will be getting by multiplying 1.25 of this gas flow rate. Okay, it can also be located by calculating the top end enthalpy, just H2 prime of this, we can say the hot water which is entering by equation L C L CWL into TL2 minus TL1 is equal to GS into H2 prime minus H1 prime, which we will be getting from the envelope 2, or we can say this one whenever we will be getting the overall, we can say this one enthalpy balance, this one across this envelope 2, or we can say this one across the entire column. Then seventh step will be the evaluate the integral in equation this NTG, we can say the number of gas phase transfer enthalpy transfer units, by integrating dH prime by HI prime minus H prime from H 1 prime to H 2 prime. So, this one starting from the bottom to the top, the whatever the change in the enthalpy we can say, will be getting by integrating the integral part, and this one we can calculate the height of the gas phase enthalpy transfer unit, that HTG, like using this equation GS by KY prime into A bar, and KY prime and HLA prime, these are required for this particular problem, these are given. So, a set of parallel lines, that is we can say the tie lines will be with the slope of this minus HL into A prime by KY prime into A bar, that is drawn between the operating line and the equilibrium line. Equilibrium line we have drawn from the saturation enthalpy line with temperature, and the operating line we have obtained from the between these two station the of this operation, that is bottom line of the cooling tower and the top line of the cooling tower. So, in between this we can see this one operating line we have. So, in between this one whatever the area under the curve, that we can get from graphically or numerically just by integrating this dTL by I prime minus H prime from TL 1 to TL 0 or TL 2, and HTG will be LCWL by KY prime into A bar. So, for this case we do not require any, we can say this one as this all the gas phase enthalpy transfer unit is expressed in terms of individual gas phase enthalpy transfer units. So, this step 8 and step 9, these will not be required. Now, we can start the solution of this given problem. Now, we shall start solving the problem. For that whatever the data we have, we shall first write down those, like say TG1, that is given as 30 degree Celsius, and TW is equal to TAS for this air water system is given as 25 degree Celsius. So, we will be getting this whatever the humidity we have, so we will be getting from the psychrometric chart. Let us start with this, say TG is equal to 30 degree Celsius like this point, and then we will be following this, we say adiabatic saturation line. So, we will be following this line like this, and we have this 25 degree Celsius somewhere, it is here, and say we will be following this, and from there, so we will be moving towards this, we can say 100% saturation line or 100% humidity line, from there we will be getting whatever the humidity. So, that we can say Y1 will be getting as, say this is we are getting as, so from psychrometric chart, so we shall get this Y 1 prime, that is equal to say 0.019. Okay. Now, we can get this humidity in that 0.019 humidity, what is the say we can say enthalpy value, or we can say this one bottom condition of the cooling tower will be getting calculating this enthalpy value, which is say of the liquid water or cold water leaving the we can say cooling tower. So, that H 1 prime, so that actually we will be getting as from this we can say equation, we have this 1.005 plus 1.88 into this Y 1 prime, that is 0.019 into T temperature, that is T G 1 minus T 0, that is we can say 30 minus 0, that is 30 plus 2500 into say y1 prime, so 0.019. So the enthalpy value is coming out as 78.7 kilojoule per kg. So now we have this h1 prime and say Tg1. So we know now the condition of the bottom of this cooling tower. So that we can say this Q point, we need to locate now, locate this Q point, that is we can say, say suppose say TL1 and H1 prime. Okay. So that we can say lower terminal of this cooling tower. In say TLH plane, like whatever we have this TLH plane, here we will be getting this, say that say TL1, we can say this TL1 is equal to say 30 degree Celsius, that is given, and enthalpy value is 78.7 kilojoule per kg. So we have this lower point here. Okay. So that is actually we have identified. Now we will be doing this say equilibrium curve generation. Say whatever the equilibrium curve we have, we shall generate this one. So generation of equilibrium say curve. So that actually we will be doing this one, we will be getting this equilibrium curve, we can generate very easily for this, we can say temperature range, say from where actually we have started, say let us take for our case, we can start from 20 degree Celsius to say 47 degree Celsius. In this range the entire cooling tower will be operating. Okay. So for that case we will be doing the step by step calculation, like say calculate this vapor pressure, this from this Antoine equation, that is nothing but this ln P V A is equal to, that is in bar actually, that is equal to, so 11.96481 minus 3984.923 divided by T minus 39.724. Okay. So that temperature in Kelvin and pressure actually is in bar. So from here we will be getting that PA value, or we can say vapor pressure value will be getting from there, and then we will be getting, so we can say the second step will be like this, say y prime, that is we can say this humidity value, that will be like this P V by total pressure minus P V, that is into molecular weight of water 18.02 by air molecular air 28.97. Okay. So we will be getting this y prime. Then we will be getting this H prime, actually enthalpy we need. So, for a particular temperature, whatever the enthalpy value will be, so we will be taking again that say equation 1.005 plus 1.88 into Y prime, that is into Tg, into Tg minus T0 plus 2500 into Y prime. Okay. The T0 actually we take this one as this, we can say this reference temperature, that is 0 degree Celsius. Okay. Now we will be generating this, we can say equilibrium this one curve values, like we can say we will be getting for a particular temperature what is this enthalpy value. Okay. So now we can start with this, suppose we can take one temperature, So then for that we will be getting this, from this Antoine equation we will be getting ln PV value. From there we will be getting just exponential of this ln PV will be PV, and then we will be getting say y prime. From there we will be getting h prime. Okay. So for every temperature we will be getting this enthalpy values, then we will be putting this one in h prime and t curve or in the plane, then we will be getting this equilibrium line. Okay. So let us start from from 21 degree Celsius, then from this Antoine equation we will be getting this ln PV value is equal to -3.6945. Okay. Then PV value will be this very small value 0.0248. Okay. And from there we will be getting this humidity value, that is also very less 0.01564, and the enthalpy value will be getting this from that equation 1.005 plus 1.88 into y prime into Tg minus T0 plus 2500 into y prime. So from there we will be getting 60.844. So for 21 degree Celsius, suppose this is that point. Now for 23 degree Celsius, again we will be getting this that value actually 3.572, then PV value will be getting 0.028, then y prime will be getting to some extent higher 0.01773, then enthalpy value will be say greater than the enthalpy value obtained at 21 degree Celsius, that is at 68.229. So then we will be getting, suppose for 25 degree Celsius we will be getting -3.4572, then PV value will be getting 0.0316, and y prime value will be getting 0.02, then enthalpy value will be getting 76.24. Okay. So that way we will be getting say, let us take say we can get this one for 41 degree Celsius, the ln PV value will be say -2.553, and PV value will be say 0.0778. And then y prime value will be 0.0551, and this enthalpy value will be 174.578. Then again say 45 degree Celsius will be getting say -2.344. And the PV value will be 0.0958, and y prime value will be obtained as 0.065, and the enthalpy value will be obtained as 213.2463. Okay. And for 47 degree Celsius, this ln PV value will be -2.24, and PV value will be 0.106, and y prime value will be 0.0728, and the enthalpy value will be 235.69. Okay. So all these values actually now we need to put in this enthalpy temperature plot, and then we will add these lines to get this saturation humidity. We need to remember that say the Antoine equation is like this, ln PV is equal to 11.9648 - 3984.923 divided by T minus 39.97, and temperature should be converted into Kelvin from Celsius temperature, and y prime will be PV by P minus PV into molecular weight of water by molecular weight of air, and then enthalpy will be say 1.005 plus 1.88 into y prime into Tg minus T0 plus 2500 into y prime. Okay. Now we have this identified this point, that is we can say bottom point of the cooling tower, and we have this equilibrium saturation line, or we can say this one equilibrium curve. Now we need to draw a tangent from this bottom point to the saturation curve. So we have to draw this tangent and it will be like this. Okay. So whenever we will be draw a tangent to the equilibrium line, say suppose through Q, suppose this one, this black line, actually we can say we need to draw this. So first we have identified this bottom point, then we have drawn this equilibrium line, and then we have drawn a tangent to the we can say equilibrium line through Q. So then we need to find the slope of this, we can say this one, slope of this we can say line is obtained as, say we can say 8.78. So from this, for any point actually we need to take, for any two points, if we take that, what is this value, what is the value of enthalpy and what is the value of temperature, from the enthalpy difference and temperature difference we will be getting this slope. Okay. So that slope indicates that the minimum air flow rate required to run the this cooling tower. Okay. So that we can say this one, so GS, gas flow rate minimum, will be getting like, so just by using that equation whatever we have derived for this design of cooling tower, L CWL divided by, say we can say this slope. Okay. So now we have this L is equal to say 5500 into CWL, we know that this 4.187 divided by slope we have obtained at 8.78. Okay. So from here actually we will be getting this GS minimum, or minimum air flow rate required to run this cooling tower to cool this one from 45 to 30 degree Celsius. So we are getting as say 2623 say kg per hour meter square. So this GS minimum is this one, so 2623 kg per hour meter square. Okay. But in the problem it is given as the actual flow rate, gas, or we can say this air flow rate, is equal to 1.25 times of GS minimum. Okay. So it is coming out as 1.25 into 2623 kg per hour into meter square. So it is coming out as 3279 kg per hour meter square. So now we have got this gas flow rate, or air flow rate, say we can say GS is equal to 3279 kg per hour meter square. Now we have this one, suppose we have this equilibrium line, and then we have this bottom point, we have this tangent, from there we got this minimum gas flow rate. But now we have this 3279 kg per hour meter square actual gas flow rate. So using that we will be getting the, what is the actual slope of this cooling tower. So for that case we can say this one, slope of this operating line, if we say this is the equilibrium condition or minimum requirement, but what is the slope of the actual operating line of the we can say cooling tower, slope of say operating line. So that we will be getting as, so we can see this slope using the same formula, like we can say L CWL by say gas flow rate. Okay. So L CWL by this gas flow rate, actual GS, so that is coming out as 5500 into 4.187 divided by 3279. So now we are getting the slope as 7.02. So this is, you see, lower than this one, but initially minimum flow rate, it was 8.78, now the slope is 7.28. Just using this slope of the 7.28, suppose this slope was the slope of this line which touches the equilibrium line, that was 8.78. Now we will be drawing one line whose slope is equal to 7.02. So now we have this, this is called, we can say, operating line. Okay, this is operating line. Okay, now we will be doing this mass balance. So whenever we will be doing this L CWL into TL2, for the entire cooling tower, LCWL into TL2 minus say TL1, that will be like this, GS into H2 prime minus H1 prime. So now everything is known except this H2 prime. Okay. So we will be putting this 5500 into 4.187 into TL2 is given that 45 degree Celsius and TL1 is the 30 degree Celsius. Is equal to GS is obtained as 3279 into say H2 prime minus H1 prime is obtained as 78.7. So, from here actually we will be getting H2 prime, that is the enthalpy of this water entering from the top of this cooling tower, means this from the station 2. Okay. So, that is actually obtained as 184 kilojoule per kg. So, now we have this, suppose 184 kilojoule per kg like this one. So, we will be coming to this, and so this is, we can say, whenever this operating line touches this 184, then we can say, and also you see this is the 45 degree Celsius, we see this is 45 degree Celsius, say TL2. That is, we can say 45 degree Celsius and TL1, that is say 30 degree Celsius. So, we have this point, so we can say top of this cooling tower is now identified. Okay. So, now we know this one, the relation is given, say HL A bar is equal to, is given as say 0.059 into L to the power 0.51 into GS. Okay. So, that is nothing but 0.059 into liquid flow rate as 5500 to the power 0.51 into GS is equal to that 3279. Okay. So, that is coming out as 15637.9 say kilocalorie per meter cube hour Kelvin. That is, we can say, is equal to say 15637.9 into say 4.187, so that is kilojoule per meter cube hour Kelvin. So, that is coming out as 65475.9 kilojoule per meter cube hour Kelvin. Okay. So, we will be getting the slope of the tie line, because for that we need this HLA. So, slope of the tie line, because you see the slope of the tie line, we do not know this in which direction. Suppose we know now this equilibrium line, then we know this bottom point, we know this top point, we have this operating line, and then this operating line. Now, we will be drawing the slope of the slope. If we know the slope of the tie line, then we will be drawing from this point to equilibrium line, and in between this one, whatever the area under the curve, from there we will be getting HTOG. Okay. So, the slope of the tie line, actually we can say this tie line, that is, we can say HLA by KY prime A. Okay. So, that is, we have got this HLA is 65475.9 divided by KY A prime is equal to, that is given that 5743.5. Okay. So, that is minus actually. So, that is coming out as minus 11.4. Okay. So now we have this slope of the tie line as -11.4. So that will be like this. So now we can draw so many tie lines from bottom point to the top point of the cooling tower, means in between this one we are trying to get the area under the curve. So for that actually we are drawing these tie lines. In between this we can say P1, this is 1.2, 2 point, or we can say this one in between the two stations of the cooling tower or bottom point to the top point. Okay. Now say a set of tie lines of slope -11.4 is drawn. So that depends on the individual. So how many slopes actually we will be drawing? If we draw more slopes, tie lines, then we can say the accuracy will be more. If we draw very less number of tie lines, then we can say accuracy, the area under the curve will be less. Okay. So all the tie lines touch the equilibrium line and it started from the operating line. Now we need to get the value of this integration, we can say TL1 to TL2 DTLY, so HI prime H prime, okay, H prime. So we need to get this one. Okay. So for that we can do the graphical evaluation, means say what we need to do, we have this area under the curve, so in between this operating line and this equilibrium line. Okay. So we will be doing this one graphically, this part actually we will be doing graphically. So for that what we can do, we can take any TL, for that we can say H prime, and then we can get say TLI, then we can say get HI prime, and ultimately we will be getting HI prime minus H prime. Okay. So we will be computing this very simply, we can calculate those, and let us take this TL1 is 30 degree Celsius. So we will be continuing from 30 degree Celsius to this 45 degree Celsius. Okay. So for 30 degree Celsius, so H1 prime will be like this 78.7, that is already calculated, and for that actually TLI, that is on the equilibrium line, that actually will be obtained as 28.7, and the corresponding enthalpy value will be say obtained as from here actually will be getting like 93. Okay. And then 1 by HI prime minus H prime, that will be obtained as 0.07. Okay. So now for any temperature, what is the value of 1 by HI prime minus H prime that we have obtained? Like that, so we can say, we can write for 32.5 degree Celsius. Similarly, we will be getting this H prime is equal to 96.4, and then TLI, that is on the equilibrium line, will be getting at edge 31.4, and enthalpy value at equilibrium point will be 107.5. We can read from this enthalpy temperature curve, or we can get this from this Antoine equation also, we can get the same thing for this equilibrium enthalpy value if we know this equilibrium temperature. Okay. And then we will be getting 1 by HI prime minus H prime as 0.09. Okay. Now we will be getting this for 35 degree Celsius, we will be calculating this, we know this H prime will be like 112.8, and this TLI will be like this 33.9 degree Celsius, and then enthalpy value will be 123.2, and this 1 by HI prime minus H prime, that will be 0.096. Okay, then 37.5 degree Celsius will be getting this enthalpy value as 130.3, and the corresponding TLI will be 36.6, okay, and then enthalpy value will be 139.9, and then 1 by hi prime minus h prime will be 0.104. So, for 40 degree Celsius will be getting this enthalpy value as 148.8, and then temperature at the equilibrium line that will be 39, and enthalpy value will be corresponding enthalpy value will be 158.4, and the difference 1 by the difference will be 0.085. Okay, that is also, that is 0.104. Okay, and then for 42.5 degree Celsius, that enthalpy value will be 165.3, temperature will be at the equilibrium 41.4, and enthalpy value will be 177, and then 1 by hi prime minus h prime will be 0.085. And for 45 degree Celsius, that is the top of this cooling tower, that enthalpy value will be 184, that is we have already obtained this 184, and whenever it will be reaching this equilibrium line, their temperature will be say 43.7, and at that temperature the enthalpy value will be 198.8. Okay. So, then 1 by hi prime minus h prime will be 0.068. Okay, so now we have this, all this TL value with 1 by hi prime minus h prime. Okay, the integration will be doing now, we will be now putting this one in this graph paper, say like this. We will start from this 30 degree Celsius to 45 degree Celsius, and then so these all the values, actually whatever we have this starting from this, for 30 degree 0.070 to we can say 45 degree Celsius, that is 0.068. So, this area under the curve actually will be getting this one. Okay. So, the entirely we will be getting this area under the curve. Okay. So, now we will be getting that whatever the area under the curve, from there we will be getting this NTG. Okay. That is, we can say area under the curve. So, that will be, we can say, we can start from this whatever this enthalpy value 184 minus 78.7, and the what is the average value of this 1.088. Okay. So, from here we will be getting this 9.27. So, we can say this NTG is 9.27, and say HTG, that is we can say this GS by KY prime into A. Okay. So, GS that is we have 3279. Divided by k y a prime, that is obtained as 5743.5. So, now it is obtained as this height of this transfer, every transfer unit is obtained as 0.56 meter. So, now we have, we can say, say total tower height will be say NTG into HTG. So, that is we can say 9.27 into 0.56 56 meter. Now it is obtained as 5.19 meter. So the total tower height is obtained as 5.19 meter. Okay. So that is the end of this calculation. So thank you very much. In the next class we will be discussing on the design calculation of the cooling tower based on the overall enthalpy transfer unit.